Just focus on God. The same God who brought you out on last week is the same God.
A leader has to stand before his people and say, look, I really don't know what to do. This army is getting ready to come, and if the enemy has his way, they will destroy us. What do you do when the person that you're looking up to don't have the answer? Wow. What do you do when the person you think should have the answer don't have the answer? What do you do after you fast? Watch this. After you've been fasting and praying, but you yet can't hear from God. What do you do after you are in charge? It's people's lives that are on the line. But yet you have to lead them, but you really don't know what to do. I know this is a cliche, but it's real simple. You just got to stay focused on God. It may be hard for some people, but when you really spiritual, like how you say you are, you should be able to just focus on God. Jehoshaphat stood before his people. Watch this. A great king stood before his people, and he said, I really don't know what to do. But the only thing I can tell you all is to just stay focused on God. Somebody shout, I have to stay focused on God. Watch this. Then God answers Jehoshaphat's prayer. God, I really don't have the finances, but I know that you are going to meet the need. God, I really don't have the gas in my car, but I'm going to try to make my way to church anyway. God, I really want to get married, but I don't have the finance, but I know that you are able. God, I really, really, really want to live for you. I really want to do this. Somebody shout, stay focused. On God. Watch this, through verse 13 through 15, God answers Jehoshaphat's prayer. He answers Jehoshaphat's prayer. The promise was given to a prophet. Watch this. Now all Judah, with their little ones, their wives and their children, they stood before the Lord. Then the Spirit of the Lord came upon Jehazel, the son of Zechariah, the son of Benaiah, the son of Jehiel, the son of Mattaniah, a Levite of the sons, in the midst of the assembly, and he said, listen, all of you of Judah, and you inhabitants of Jerusalem, and you King Jehoshaphat, thus said the Lord to you, do not be afraid nor dismayed because of this great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but it's God's. Right when you was getting ready to throw in the towel, God blocked that thing, right? Right when you was getting ready to give up on your marriage, the man of God came and said, not yet. Right when you was getting ready to kill somebody, the Spirit of the Lord came in and he spoke to you. Right when you was getting ready to light that blunt, God came in and convicted your spirit. Somebody shout, there's a prophet in my life, there's a prophet.
Chasing
dreams, chasing dreams, but you haven't chased the word that came out of the prophet's mouth.
My God.
See, you tried to chase the things that you want in life, but the Bible says, I don't know if you read yours, but my Bible says, if you seek ye first the kingdom of God, and all these righteous, then all these things shall be added unto you. Somebody shout and look at a neighbor and say, neighbor, why are you not successful? Why are you not successful? Why are you still here? Why? Because if the prophet declared it, you got to believe. your holiness right. I know y'all look at some stars and you say, Lord, I wish I had a swag. But God said, I'm looking for some folks that got a Holy Ghost swag. That when folks see you, they gonna say, God, I want to be, the God that you serve, I want that same God. The God you pray to, I want that same God. And I pray, somebody look at his neighbor and say, neighbor, what's like a Holy Ghost swag? We gonna shout now, and I want to hold it. They gonna shout. But I believe that we in the household tonight, when we got some holy folks.
Prayer change. I believe that prayer changes.
I know that prayer changes things.
Now I was in a real bad abusive relationship, knowing that there was no way for me to live. A young girl like me, raised up in a good family, way too young to endure such misery. And every night I cry myself to sleep from all the pain. And the more I pray for sunny days, it seems to rain.
He's hit me
at any given time.
He's hit me
for no reason at all.
He's hit me
so, so hard.
He's hit me.
My God, sometimes I'd fall. Mama asked what happened to me, and I take up for him. She said the devil's a liar, and pray God get rid of him. And now I'm going to school, hitting those books, I'm doing fine. He's out my life, I'm not confused, got peace of mind. Man, I tell you,
prayer changes,
it changes,
prayer changes,
oh, it changes,
prayer changes,
I'm a witness,
prayer changes,
said I know,
prayer changes,
it changes,
prayer changes,
it changes,
prayer changes,
I'm a living witness,
prayer changes things.
I was a freshman in college, and I had just made it on the basketball team.
Yeah.
I had all the skills it took to make it, but on my grades I would get nothing but all D's.
Whoa.
And the coach came to me and had a talk with me about my career. Said if you don't get your grades up, I'm gonna have to sit you down this year. Man, as tough as I was, I'd break down and cry, 'cause everybody knows me, knows that basketball is my life.
Algebra,
I studied hard.
Chemistry,
I gave my all.
Calculus,
oh my God.
English,
so many flaws. Playing ball didn't look too good for me.
Yeah.
My future could not see. Ooh. I had lost all.